Hello, my name is Lucia. I work for Ceres at the NOAA Labs in Boulder, Colorado. Sometimes I give tours of our facility. Today, I'd like you to join me as we take a glimpse at the science that's being done at the NOAA Labs in Boulder, Colorado. The Space Weather Prediction Center is an operational center within the National Weather Service and is one of two National Weather Service forecast offices located in Boulder, Colorado. The Space Weather Prediction Forecast Office is staffed 24/7 every day of the year, and its forecasters monitor the sun for space weather phenomenon and provide forecasts and warnings of space weather threats so users can mitigate impacts. So what are they looking for? There are many types of space weather events. However, three space weather-related storms are of particular note: solar flares, geomagnetic storms, and radiation storms. These phenomena all happen with increased frequency and stronger intensity as the sun's magnetic field becomes more chaotic, but less often as the sun's magnetic field stabilizes. This fluctuation in the sun is called the solar cycle and is about 11 years in length, having both a minimum and maximum of activity. More frequently, in and around solar maximum, localized strong magnetic fields may reveal themselves visibly as sunspots. When these magnetic fields become too stressed, they may instantly reconnect into less stressful alignments, causing sudden bursts of enormous amounts of electromagnetic energy, known as solar flares. Geomagnetic storms are disturbances in the Earth's magnetic field, usually caused by dramatic changes in the continuous outflow of particles and plasma streaming from the sun, called the solar wind. The more intense geomagnetic storms are usually a result of explosive releases of billions of tons of solar material into space, called a coronal mass ejection, or CME. CMEs also carry a strong embedded magnetic field along with them, furthering potential interactions with Earth's magnetic field and possibly leading to more intense geomagnetic storms. CMEs can reach Earth in as quick as 18 hours, but usually they arrive in 2 to 4 days. Radiation storms may take place when highly energetic protons suddenly accelerate along magnetic field lines stretching out from the sun into space. These storms are often associated with solar flares and CMEs and can reach Earth in as quick as tens of minutes. Most of us never notice space weather events because we are very well protected by our atmosphere and magnetosphere. So why does Space Weather Prediction Center forecast space weather? Because these types of space weather storms may impact our navigation technologies, radio communication, satellites, aviation, and spaceflight, and potentially the electrical power grid. More specific examples include: outside the atmosphere, astronauts' health may be severely affected by radiation storms. GPS can become less accurate. Satellites can be bombarded with ions and negatively impact onboard electronics. Certain radio bands can experience blackout conditions, making communication difficult or impossible for pilots and emergency workers. Even the power grid could become overwhelmed due to a sudden increase in current caused by severe or extreme geomagnetic storms. However, with warnings from the Space Weather Prediction Center, precautions and other protective measures may be taken in advance. There is one way you might see space weather in action, though. That is by the appearance of the aurora, the dancing, shimmering curtains of light in the night sky. The aurora appears when geomagnetic storms reach enough intensity due to various and favorable atmospheric and magnetic interactions. These lights are most visible at night near the poles and can happen when solar particles interact with gases in our atmosphere in just the right way. You can learn more about space weather and see forecasts at spaceweather.gov. Take a look around our outreach pages to learn more about all we have to offer. Have a good day and stay curious.